Welcome back. We're here for another good time on the workshop, and this one is the AMT Ford 1971 Mustang Mach 1 in 1/25th scale. Check out the sweet retro box art on there. They always do such a nice job of it. You can see some color options there. You can see the yellow car on there quite a few times. We got the green one, a red one. Gives you a hint on what color to paint the engine. I also like that this picture here illustrates that not every single Mach 1 had all the side striping and all that stuff done. You can see it's a cool green color. It's just got the black rockers on it with the back stripe, but there's not a whole bunch of stuff on the sides, and sometimes having something a little plain, a little sleeper, is nicer than the big flashy muscle car. So let's take a look at everything that'll be in the box when this is available and you can get yours. I will link down in the description where you can get this bad boy on pre-order and have it ready as soon as it's available to the general public. We got the dashboard here, which looks nice. There is a very fine wood grain in the center, so we can put that plastic wood on there. We got the stock steering wheel. We got some what looks like there's going to be option parts in this kit. This looks like either exhaust outlets or roll cage parts. We've got the interior tub on this one. The back seat's molded completely in with the doors. The doors do have detail. You can hear it in there, but it is somewhat shallow, and we've got that nice center console with the teeny tiny little gauge package in the front there. We've got the awesome looking Mach 1 hood, the scoops on there, batteries. This does have side mirrors, package trunk on this one. We've got our radiator. We've got the blank out center tunnel shifter. That's a seat back. That's what that is right there. On this tree here, we've got the block halves, cylinder heads, all of our engine parts. Nice detail on the intake there. We've got our upper and lower front body pieces. We've got grill work in the center with the nice Mustang logo. We've got a roll cage part. We've got our rear body work. We've got another intake, you can see. We've got a racing harness and seat belts. Love when they put the seat belts in there. That makes for an awesome time. On this one of my favorite parts, check out those louvers molded open. Be very careful when cutting these free. That is super close to the edge. We don't want to gouge that. A good set of clippers. We've got another engine block and transmission halves, manifolds, cylinder heads. Looks like two entire engines in this kit. Didn't know that when I started looking at the box. That's why I like to do these previews. More roll cage parts. We've got a dash metal panel with gauges on it instead of the stock dash. You parts guys are going to love that one. Wheel backs on a little tiny tree. We've got our main chassis here. Frame parts. Front suspension sway bar. Easy to detail. A little bit of wash or a wash, a dry brush will bring those out. And it looks like we got different height options for the car. I'll have to figure out which one to do stock height with. You can see our inner fenders in there. We've got a racing bucket seat. We've got stock sport bucket seats. They look very nice on there. We got our suspension and drive line. Drive shaft, back of the transmission are all one piece with the suspension. Two-piece dual exhaust. Again, those nice seats. Giant stinking hood scoop option for that. What else we got? We still got more parts. We got our firewall. We got part of our front end, it looks like. More exhaust manifolds. Another transmission. Wide wheel backs. Air cleaner. Man, this thing's a ton of spare parts in there. We got wheel spindles. Don't lose those if we got to use them. And the Mach 1 body, nicely molded, a little bit of excess here. We'll just have to clip that off, not a problem. Got that fastback body on it. Looks molded clean, got our little trunk key insert there. Door handles look nice, panel lines. The door creases look good. You can always scribe those out a little deeper. I like the body trim on the side is nice and prominent. Got our grill detail molded in. nice holes where we'll put those front body pieces on. No guess to where those will line up to. Nicely done. So let's switch to the other side of the desk with the other parts we can take a look at. We've got two clear trees, back window, windshield. Super, super clear, no bubbles on those. We've got headlights and turn markers, parking lights. We've got transparent red taillights. They are molded with relief on there, so you'll be able to get those into their spots. Check it out. AMT's got some of the sweetest tires in the business. Firestone wide ovals, wide tread, black on the other side, hollow, so they will fit over any wheel tire combination quite easily. They look to be all the same width, so we don't have bigs and littles on this one. They all look to be the exact same size. What else we got going on? We've got a steel axle. We've got two sets of wheels on this beautiful chrome tree, valve covers, blower intake, alternator. We got the nice rear body trim, the nice grill trim, big fan carburation on there, shifters. We got, are those wheelie bars? Could be. Track bars on the back there. All nice chrome parts tree. Super detailed, loving the wheels. Got the dish chromes. Got the fancy wheels. You can go all out. I know you Mustang guys are going to like that. And then the decal sheet. And man, is there a lot of striping on this thing. We got the black stripes. We got the silver stripes. Mach 1 in silver. Mach 1 in black. We've got all of our marker lights, gauges done. We got all of our striping. We got all the hood striping. The hood striping is to put that outside stripe around the black if you choose to black out the hood like that. We've got the Mach 351 Ram Air logos in black, white. We got white gauges, black gauges. We got the 351 four valve engine markings on there for the air cleaner, Mustang logos. This thing is full of goodies. All those stripes are redone in silver and black, multiple license plates, and some little AMT logos to hide on the car somewhere when you build it. Also, if you don't like any of those wheel choices, I showed these in the Ecto-1 build. AMT's got coming out a custom and competition spokes and stripes, wheels and tires. That's the part number you'll want to look for. Gold stripe and red stripe on the other side. Custom chrome mag wheels, a nice parts pack. Always like that stuff. I'm going to get to building my Mach 1, and I'll be right back. I think even if you want to add some parts like I'm doing to the kit, sub-assembly time rolls up in like 45 minutes on this car. It does not take long. I've also pulled up some things. The instructions will have you wait to attach things like the front bumper and air dam spoiler or whatever. Later, if you don't mind masking around stuff, you can attach them right away in the beginning, as we'll see, because it's all going to fit together just fine. Same will attaching the rear before you paint everything. So you decide how you want to assemble it. This is how I'm going to do mine, and I've already test fit to make sure that it's not a problem whatsoever. I'm adding the louvers to mine, so I've cut them out cleanly on the most narrow side. This side has a nice gap on it, so we can just go ahead and paint those. And since they're black, we can touch up that edge when we cut them free. But those are nice, and I think they're going to look like a nice option with the colors I've picked for the car. The mirrors and the hood are near each other on the tree, so I just cut around them. We'll get them all painted up the body color and be able to work with those later. We got the wheel backs all set up. I got the spindles glued in the front end. The back takes the metal axle. So we've got those ready to be painted behind those chrome dish wheels. We've got the exhaust off on its own tree, so we can paint that. We've got our air cleaner separated and on its own tree, so we can paint that with the radiator lines. We've got the radiator itself, the battery, and the horns all one color, and you can individually detail those going forward. So I've got those on their own tree. We can get those painted up as well, get that all done. Definitely using the seat belts if they're in the kit. I always like to use them. When you look in the little window, it makes a big, big difference. Belt and pulley system. I'll leave the alternator chrome, but the fan, I don't want chrome on this model. So I glued that in place. The spoiler, if you want to put it on, can be an act in frustration. I did get it in there. I'm not sure how perfectly straight it's going to be once it's on, but the little legs of the spoiler glued on, I put them on with super glue to hold them on tight, and we'll hope that I can get that on the body and looking sharp when it's all ready to go. When we're all done, I'll get that painted on its own. The seats and the differential will all get painted up together. I'm going to do a dark interior on this car anyways, and then we will detail the seats individually as we go. The rear light housing on the Mustang, we see in the pictures, is 99% black aside from the trim around the edges and the taillights, and the gas cap is a separate piece. So instead of trying to paint that little center section black, what I like to do is paint the entire thing black, then use my chrome or silver markers to highlight just the trim. And that works out well for me. I will do that on video. You will get to see me do it. We've got the dashboard and the steering wheel. Speaks enough. We can clip on, we can get those painted, and then we can detail our dashboard by hand later. The 351, not the absolute best engine in a model kit. It does have some caveats to fit inside this chassis, but it is a nice representation that will look just fine under the hood. I glued it all together, one, so you could see it assembled, two, because I don't mind hand painting a ton of stuff. We got the transmission, we got the oil pan on, water pump housing. I did have to shave off some on the front end to get the water pump housing to fit level, and trim a little off the front of the oil pan to get that to sit flat on the front of the engine. Just took a sander and sanded it down and made it fit a little better. I wasn't too worried about it. Got the distributor in place, got the exhaust in place, and the cylinder heads and the intake. We will then attach the chrome valve covers at a later point in time, and we've got the starter glued in. So I will get that painted up and then hand detail that as well. The body, as you can see, test fits together super, super easily. And that's why I say you can go ahead and attach that front end. I did end up with gaps on the front end and the back end. I filled those with a gel super glue. It fills in nicely. That's why you can still see the gap on video. But on paint, most of that will cover up. Same as in the rear. There are gaps on either side when you line it up with the bottom. There's gaps there, there, and a little bit there. Not huge, but from the back I inject super glue gel real thick, use a Q-tip to wipe it off the front and level it out, and that's as good as I'm going to worry about it. The back end fits in nicely. The front end fits in nicely and looks well. And then all I have to do is mask off and get my black around the bottom when I'm all ready to say I've got the color coat on. Now this comes apart very easily. The chassis just drops in. No prep work on that. That's ready to be painted. The interior, what I did was it lines up with that ring, and there's a little pin back there that it fits in. I put that in. Then I put the firewall in. Then I took my fingers and I pushed down on the doors when I glued in that firewall. That means when I push down, the firewall goes to the top, the doors are level with the interior, and I don't have to worry about if I pushed in the interior all the way. You can see that little bit of a gap there. If I push that all the way down, the top of the doors would stick up way above the inside of the doors, so we don't want that. So that's how I glued that in, and that comes apart just that easy. You'll be able to get that in and out super, super easy. And since this is all going to be black, this is going to be black, we don't have to worry about it. Really easy to work on. You can see how that front end lines up quite nicely. A minor gappage. Not going to worry about that at all. I'm going to get everything over to paint, and I'll see you over there.
Thank you.
I have less than an hour's worth of work, I think, left on the 71 Mach 1. We've got everything put together as far as I want to go before I do the final, put it all together and put my decals on. Being this nice champagne gold color of the body with the black trim on the bottom, I definitely want to go with the black decals on mine. Got the grill together, all pieced together, got the lights in, the little air dam on the bottom. I even went and put my louvers on. You can see the difference between flat black primer there and flat black actual paint meant to be black. They have a different texture. The primer is a much rougher texture, looks awesome on carpet and stuff, and reacts very well when you clear coat it to look like vinyl. On the actual parts that I want to be painted flat black, I like to use the spray flat black for that reason, and I'll say flat black just one more time for fun. We've got that all detailed on there, everything around. We got the back end together. I have to put the rear bumper on. We got the taillights in, the gas cap, the louvers are on. The interior is done. I did a black on black just because I like how it goes with the whole theme of the car. The dashboard comes out nice. The dashboard is very detailed on this kit. We got the interior done. I wood grained the doors and the dashboard just the way you saw. I paint a craft paint on. I use a very stiff brush so that the black paint carries through, and that way it looks like that imitation wood grain, or even wood, real wood grain. We got the seat belts on, which when we gloss up the vinyl seats and the door panels and the dashboard and the console, those seat belts in their fabric really stand out and look awesome and add a lot to that interior. So I like that. It looks nice. It's very basic, yet gives us a great look of the Mach 1. On the chassis, now the tires are going to fall off because they're just loosely pressed in, because the manual is very indescript on which holes to use. They have one hole here and two holes here, but there's three and there's three. So I don't know exactly which one to use. I just kind of put them in there so that when I put the body on, I can reason and find out at what height I want them to go in. But right now, as you can see, that passenger side just fell off. I just kind of stuck it in one of the three options on there, and the rear axle I did right in the center. So we'll see how it sits, and I can always adjust that. But they push in nicely. There's no real issues. The steel axle squeezes right into the wheelbacks. You didn't have to fight it. You didn't have to cut any metal off or anything. And it looks nice. That wheel and tire package is very handsome, especially when you do the black wash. We've got the 351 under the hood. We've got the battery. We've got the radiator in place. We've got the belt and pulley system, and we've got the exhaust underneath. I just did a light dry brushing to show all that lovely detail under there. Glued the exhausts in place with super glue. Did the rear axle so that it stands out with its flat tones for the springs and a little bit of glossier tone for that differential. And that is all set to go. So that's really it with the kit. What I still have to attach are these mirrors, which aren't so hot, but hey, it's got mirrors in it, so we'll put them on. The air cleaner, I got to put the decal on the air cleaner once I glue it into place on the carburetor. And then the lovely spoiler, which will mount on the back like so. And we will be done after I get all these little pieces of stripes on there. And we'll have to get it around the tailgate and everything. And then we'll get it around the body. That's going to take a little bit. And then we got to put the black stripes along the black stripe on the bottom and get that done. Put the marker lights on around the body. Get our air cleaner decal on. And we are set to go. I will see you back when we have the final. you are one of the millions of Mustang fans out there, then AMT's 125th scale Ford 1971 Mustang Mach 1 is a good kit for you to pick up. It assembles super easy. It's a very, very simple kit. It's got great interior details, more than I thought it would. The engine is a nice representation of the 351. It's not the best on the market. It's not the most amazing, but it looks good under the hood, and that's really all that matters. It's pretty much covered with that entire giant air cleaner. The box is filled with extra parts. It looks like you almost have a complete extra engine in there, transmission, roll cage parts. We got extra wheels. We got extra intakes, carburation. It's got a ton of extra parts. Now, I wanted to build a stock Mach 1 Mustang. I wanted to go a little more subtle. I just went with the basic stripe package. I went with the louvers and the spoiler, but I omitted the giant hood stripe, just put the 350 Ram Air logos on the side, painted in the scoops, and went that way with mine because I saw one online. It was actually on a website advertising the side stripes, and it was this champagne gold color with no hood stripe. I didn't even know they were available without the hood stripe. I thought if you ordered a Mustang Mach 1, they all came with that hood stripe painted on them. But I was wrong. You could get it with the side stripes. You could get it without the side stripes, with the hood stripe, however you wanted. So I did it thinking black spoiler, black louvers, black interior with the stripe package and the black lower body. I just thought that would be a really cool look, and I'm enjoying it. It's a very subtle look for a muscle car, and I do enjoy that more than a more garish color, which is what a lot of people are going to go with. So the wheel package is beautiful. The tire package, I ended up sticking the wheels and axles in the center out of the three holes. You had one, two, three holes. I put it in the middle hole and where I did it originally, and that's where it seems to look best for me. I like where it's sitting. It resembles the box art in the height, and that's how I liked it. I also looked at it on the side there, and that seems to be where it is positioned on the side as far as how it sits over the tires. So that's how I left it. So very nice kit to build. The dash is full of detail and easy to accentuate. You saw how easy it is to put on a gloss coat over any kind of paint. I go right over the glass and everything and just avoid the stuff that I don't want to gloss too much, like the louvers and the spoiler. Leave them more their flat tone like that. The taillights go together easily. Surprisingly, though, the headlights, the markers, and that grill went around there quite well. You saw how I masked it off so I didn't have to hand paint any of that stuff, and I got all the black in the grill, yet I kept that champagne colored bumper and then did the lower black. All very easy to mask off and work on. This kit will be available shortly. I will link down in the description where you can snag it on a pre-order. And as always, this is the new year, so I want to say if you're new to the show, remember, I don't build show builds. I do quick reviews in a couple of hours of work to put them on here so you can see how the kit goes. I am not the end-all, be-all reference material for colors, ideas, factory perfect builds, or representations of cars. This guy behind the camera just loves building models for fun and showing them to all of you. So remember, it's 2022. Have fun. Smile. It's just a hobby, and we'll see all of you at the next review.